Welcome to Monday Yoga with Jim. Today we'll be starting in a standing position, so make your way to your mat and we will get started with some decompression breaths. Great. Standing with feet about shoulder width apart. Make sure the outside edges of the feet are parallel, so that creates a little internal rotation of the thighs. Knees are pretending to come together. Kind of squeezing the hips. We'll take our hang loose fingers, pinky to the top of the pelvis, thumb to that bottom rib. Inhale, expand and create space. Exhale, bring the core in, belly button towards spine to squeeze the stale air out. Elbows are active and reaching wide. Chest is up, chin is down and back. We're pressing the back of the head into an imaginary headrest. Changing the weight, carrying muscles of the neck into the front of the neck as opposed to into the back. Expanding the chest in three different dimensions. Front of the heart, or front of the chest is for the heart, the back is for the lungs. So as we inhale, expand into the back of the ribs. Feel them expand as you create space in the torso for the spine to decompress. Continuing that breath in through the nose and out through the nose. Nice and active, arms reaching wide. Lots of space being created. Shake your arms out. We're going to inhale the arms up overhead, interlace the fingers, and then point the palms up towards the ceiling. We're pressing down into the earth still. Outside edges of the feet are parallel. You're pressing down into that big toe mound, little toe mound, and heel on the feet. Shoulders are relaxed away from the ear, pressing the palms up towards the sky. Try not to flare the ribs out. It's a natural tendency to open the ribs and kind of arch the spine. We want to keep the ribs like they're stuck in a cylinder, and then just expand that cylinder every direction. And then we're going to reach the arms over to the right, pressing down through the outside edge of that left foot, exaggerating the reach. Don't flare the ribs out. Keep that space growing to the back of the body. Gaze can be straight ahead or up underneath the armpit, or reaching with that left palm, the left heel of the palm is reaching up, stretching the whole left side body here, and we're planting firmly down into the outside edge of that left foot. And come back to center, and then we'll reach to the other side, the right palm, heel of the right palm, pressing up towards the sky, pressing down through the outside edge of the right foot. Reaching the hips to the right, hands to the left. Nice long frame here. Remember, try to not flare out those ribs. Inhale and inflate the space in the back of the body. Two more breaths here. Coming back to center, we'll release the hands. Come back into those hang loose fingers. I'll turn sideways so you can see what I'm doing here. Outside edge of the feet are still parallel, pressing down through those three points of contact on each foot. Slight bend in the knees as we internally rotate the thighs, bringing the knees closer together, turning the glutes and hamstrings on. I want you to hinge a little bit at the hips. Start to bring the hips behind the knees. Knees stay stacked over the ankles, but they're bent. Hands are on those hang loose fingers, on the measuring sticks here. Feel the space you create on the inhale. Exhale, maintain it. And we'll release the hands, opening the palms forward, rotating the shoulder joint into bat wings here. Nice long, we're not pinching the shoulder blades together, we're opening that shoulder joint. Should start to feel a little bit of a stretch, maybe into the bicep almost. We're expanding all the fingers out wide. Now take a deep inhale and we'll slowly scoop the hands together and raise them up to the height of the heart. Sphere of tension with the fingers, squeezing all 10 fingers together, pulling the wrists apart, squeezing the elbows together, and then pull the shoulder blades apart. As you inhale, puff up that space between the shoulder blades and reach. Exaggerate the reach between the wrists and the hips. Remember, knees are bent, but we're not tracking the knees out forward. We're putting the weight back into the heels, hamstrings, glutes, reaching the arms forward. On your next inhale, slope the hands up above the line of the forehead, reaching the hips back. Keep that core engaged here on the exhale, hips reaching back, arms reaching forward. Weight back into the hamstrings. Lower the hands back down to height of the heart. And then on your exhale, we're going to press the hips forward, releasing the hands and lowering back into Batman. Pressing the hips forward, digging down into the earth. Great job. So heel those feet directly underneath the hips. Inhale, arms come up overhead. Exhale, forward fold, nice and slow, pressing the hands in the outside of the room as you come into our forward fold. Now I want you to take a big bend in the knees, connect your chest to your thighs. So find that chest to thigh connection, as much of a bend in the knees as you need to get there. We're gonna start to walk the fingertips forward as you press the hips up towards the sky. Maintain that chest to thigh connection, knees can stay bent. Fingertips reach forward, hips reaching back. Let the head hang between the arms. Should start to feel that right in the meat of the hamstring there. Keeping that chest to thigh connection will protect the lower back, protect the hamstrings here. The goal isn't to have super straight legs. It's to keep that connection and start to stretch out the middle of the hamstring. Two more breaths here, deep inhales. Puff up that space in the back of the body. Exhale, belly button towards spine. Morning, Bruce. Now slowly start to inch the fingertips back, and then we'll bring the hands behind the body. Interlace your fingers and press those arms up overhead. Keep that chest to thigh connection here. A slight bend in the elbows. Tighten the joints. Wiggle the toes around. Find your footprint in the mat. Pressing down to that big toe mound, little toe mound, and heel. Head hanging heavy. Elbows bent. Arms up overhead. Chest is connected to the thighs. Hamstrings start being a little fatigued here. Release the hands. Slowly start to walk the hands forward as you step the feet back into a plank. From here, we'll run through a vinyasa, nice and slow, lowering down halfway for chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Awesome. Take two deep breaths here, and then we'll start to modify our downward dog however we need, whether that be bending one knee at a time, getting into each calf and Achilles, warming up the hamstrings a little more. Maybe that means bending both knees, sinking the chest a little closer to the thighs, and then work to press the heels into the floor as you reach the hips up towards the ceiling. Again, this is your practice. Find the modification or adjustment that works best for you. Bruce is getting comfortable on the couch. And then on your next exhale, let's walk up to the front of our space, coming into a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Nice flat back, ears away from the shoulders. Exhale, forward fold. Big bend in the knees as we inhale and rise up. Hands sweep up overhead. Exhale, swan dive down, nice and slow. Hands pressing into the sides of the room as you come into a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Hands bringing the feet. Step the feet back into a plank. We'll run through a vinyasa here, lowering down halfway, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. two breaths here. And then we'll inhale that right leg up towards the sky. Exhale, step it through for low lunge. You can stay right here. You can lower that left knee down to the floor, press the top of the foot into the earth. Just kind of working into this lunge here, freeing up some space in that left hip as we compress the right hip. You can wiggle the foot around here, maybe come onto the knife edge of the foot, bring the right hand on the inside for a little bit of a runner's lunge. You know, just work to loosen up that right hip here. Inhaling, expanding the space in the back of the body. Exhale, belly button towards spine. And then on your next exhale, let's sink back into a half split or half Hanuman. Walk the fingertips back, bring the toes up off the floor. Imagining this right pinky toe is reaching for the left ear. Work to square up the hips here, so pull that right hip back, press the left hip forward. Inhale, grow through the crown of the head. Exhale, folding forward. Now, if you've taken these gentle classes before, this is a pretty common pose for this class. We're going to add a few different poses after this, so bear with me. It's the first time going through this class. We'll get there. Just keep on breathing. And then we'll inhale back up to that low lunge. This time we're going to curl the left toes under, press that left knee up. And then we'll slowly inhale the arms up overhead. Nice low lunge here. I'm gonna turn around so you can see what I'm gonna do. Now we're gonna lower the right arm and spin it behind us for a twist. Bring that right arm behind you and twist over the left or the right leg. Reaching your hands for the opposite walls. Shoulders are relaxed away from the ears. Turn that core on, press into that left heel, turn the posterior muscle chain on as we twist. Reaching, expanding. And then release that right hand, bring it back up overhead. Hands come down through heart center. Frame the foot, sweep that right leg back and run through a vinyasa here, lowering down. Halfway chaturanga, inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale. Downward facing dog. All right, inhale that left leg up towards the sky. Exhale, step it through, low lunge. Again, you can lower that right knee down to the floor, untuck the toes, press the top of the foot into the earth. As we work on this left hip now, kind of wiggle around, find any points that might feel stuck. Take a deep breath into them. Again, runner's lunge is an option here, bringing the hands to the inside of the leg, coming onto the knife edge of the left foot. Whatever is calling to you this morning. Take a deep inhale, fill up those lungs in the back of the body. Exhale, start to fold back into half Hanuman or half split, picking the left foot up off the floor. Bringing that left pinky toe towards the right ear, squaring up the hips here. So we pull that left hip back, press the right hip forward. Every inhale, grow through the crown of the head. Exhale, fold a little closer. Yoga happens in millimeters. There's no rush here. Taking your time. Turn around. Show you this transition here. Slowly start to inhale back up into that lunge. Curl the right toes under, press the right knee up. And then we'll slowly inhale the arms up overhead for a low lunge. This left knee stays behind the ankle or above it, never out past it. We're gonna drop that left arm and start to twist to the left, over the left leg. Reaching the fingertips as far as you can in opposite directions, pressing into that right heel, turning on the posterior muscle chain on that side, engaging the core. Inhale, puff up the chest. Exhale, squeeze it out. One more breath here. Inhaling. Exhale. Release that left hand. Bring it back up overhead. Shoulders relax away from the ears. Hands come down through heart center. Frame the foot. Sweep that left leg back. We'll run through a vinyasa here, lowering down halfway. Chaturanga. Inhale. Upward facing dog. Exhale. Down facing dog. Great job. All right, this is where it gets a little different. On your next exhale, walk up to the front of your space, coming into that forward fold. Toe heel the feet together. So the toes are touching and there's about an inch of space between the heels. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Bring the chest to your thighs. Sink the hips down for chair pose. Hands come next to the feet. And then inhale the arms up overhead for chair. Weight's going backwards, so it's coming into my heels. I'm reaching the glutes backwards. Should be able to look down and see your toes. And we're gonna release the hands, bring them behind you, and then come up onto your tippy toes. So you're transferring the weight into the pads of the feet for drinking bird. Nice and long, fingers reaching away. Balancing up on the pads and the toes. Inhale, back to chair pose. And then we'll step the right leg back for warrior one. Right leg comes back. Get the feet a little bit apart here, like we're on railroad tracks with the heels. If you need to, you can step that left foot out a bit. Work to square up the hips as you bring the arms up overhead. Shoulders relax away from the ears. Hands come down through heart center. Frame that left foot, sweep the leg back. Run through your vinyasa or meet us in downward dog. Let's try that on the other side. On your next exhale, walk up to the front of your space, coming into that forward fold. Toe heel the feet together, toes are touching, heels are a little bit apart. Hands come next to the feet and then sink the hips down into the chair pose as you raise the arms up. Weight's going backwards. Weight's in the heels, the hips, the glutes. Should be able to lift your toes up, maybe wave high to yourself. Coming into warrior one from here. We're gonna step that left foot back. No, we didn't do drinking bird. Let's come back into chair pose. And then float the arms back, coming up onto the toes for drinking bird. Ooh, tough to find my balance this morning. Shoulders are relaxed away from the ears, fingertips reaching for the floor behind you as you press up onto the pads of the feet. And onto the toes. Core is engaged. Bring the arms back up overhead. And sweep that left leg back for warrior one. Again, you can bring that right foot out to help square up the hips. Sink into that lunge. Right knee stays above the ankle, not in front of it. Arms sweep up overhead. Let's not flare the ribs out on our inhale. Try to puff up that space in the back of the body. Hands come down through heart center. Frame the foot, sweep that right leg back. Run through a vinyasa, lowering down halfway, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. All right. Three breaths here. Reconnect with your breath and downward dog. And then on your next exhale, start to walk the feet up between the hands. Toes come together, heels are a little bit apart. Hands sink down next to the feet as you lower the hips. Inhale the arms up overhead for chair pose again. Reaching through the fingertips like a lightning bolt. Goes straight down through the fingertips into the hips, bends to the knees, and then down into the floor. You've got it. On your next exhale, inhale all the way up, mountain pose. Now this is where it's gonna get a little tricky. Stay with me. Hands come down through heart center. Bend the right knee, open the knee to the right. Bring the foot next to the ankle for tree pose. And keep it here, bring it up to the calf or up to the inner thigh, yogi's choice. Bouncing on our tree, keeping the rib cage in, we're not expanding it up and out. Instead, we're expanding it into the back of the body. Release your hands, start to grow the branches, shoulders stay relaxed away from the ears. Now this is where the transition is gonna get interesting. We're gonna move from tree to warrior one. I'm gonna change positions. So the right foot, whether it's on the ankle, the calf, or the inner thigh, is gonna slowly sweep backwards into warrior one. So bring the right foot back, plant the foot, pressing down through the outside edge of that right heel. Remember, the feet are on railroad tracks and warrior one as opposed to a balance beam. Inhale your arms up overhead. Awesome. Coming into warrior two. Let me turn around. You drop that right heel, opening up. Now you can move that right heel back where it's in line. So we want heel to heel or heel to arch alignment with the feet for warrior two. Rotate those palms up towards the sky. And just rotate the forearms back down. Deep inhale, fill up the chest. Exhale, let it go. Make sure you look down at your left knee, you can see your big toe. If not, work to open that left hip up. We're pressing down through the outside edge of the right foot, opening this left hip up. Coming into goddess pose. Turn that left foot in. So now the feet are parallel. We're gonna bring the heels in. Toes are pointing out. Arms come up overhead and then we lower down into goddess. Or horse pose, all a bunch of different things. Try to work on chest up, driving the hips into the floor, opening the knees as much as you can. All right, let's transition back. We're gonna go back through that. So point the left toe, back out for warrior two. Oops. We'll sweep the right arm through as we do. Swing that right leg out a little bit so we're no longer on the balance beam, we're on the railroad tracks. Arm sweeps up, back into warrior one. Hands come down through heart center, and we're gonna step this right leg back into tree. So as we press down, find our tree, the right leg, whatever position works for you. And then inhale into the back of the body. Grow your branches. Shoulders relaxed away from the ears. Nice job. Two more breaths here in tree, and then we'll try the other side. It's okay to wobble around in tree, fall out, come right back into it. Trees move in the wind, so do we. Bring the knee towards midline, lower the foot down to the floor. Mountain pose, reaching up with the hands, pressing down with the feet. And we'll bring the hands down. Actually, we'll go into a chair pose right from here. So bring those toes together, heels are a little bit apart. Start to sink the hips down. Remember, knees are back, so we can see our toes in chair pose. Sink an inch lower, you've got it. And then we'll inhale up into mountain pose, coming into tree on the other side. So now we bend the left knee, open the knee to the left. Foot comes to the ankle, the calf, maybe to the inner thigh. You can bring your hands together at heart center, find your balance, and grow your branches, inhaling your arms up overhead. I'm gonna transition here so I can show you the next poses. From here, we're gonna go into warrior one. So as smooth, slow, and deliberate as you can go, release that left leg back into warrior one. Planting the foot down as if we were on those railroad tracks again. And find your warrior one. Work to square up the hips. Arms relax, the shoulders from the ears. Coming into warrior two. As you open the arms up, bring that left foot in line with the right. So we have heel to heel or heel to arch alignment. Right knee opening up so you can peek down and see your toes. Pressing down through the outside edge of the left foot. Reaching with the fingertips. Let's rotate the palms up towards the sky. That brings your shoulder blades down. Bicep is pointed up. And then just rotate the forearms back down. Core is engaged here. We're inhaling into the back of the chest. Exhale, let it go. Coming into goddess pose, we're going to turn the right foot forward, paralleling the outside edges of the feet. And then we'll bring the heels in and start to lower down into that squat. Knees track out over the toes, so if they're coming in, maybe step your foot in a little bit more, lower down. Hands together at heart center, shoulders a little back. Goddess pose. Hard. This is a tricky pose, so I like to put the weight to the outside edges of the feet and drop my hips back. You'll start to feel that turn on all the muscles in the thighs. Inhale, your arms come up overhead. Point the right foot forward again for warrior two. Warrior one, we're gonna swing that left arm, bring the left foot out with it, maybe toe heel the right leg out, get a little room for the hips to square up. Right leg trembling a little bit, mine is. Now we're gonna transition into tree from here. So let's bring the hands to heart center as you sweep that left knee to your tree, whether that's calf, ankle, maybe into the inner thigh. Inhale, grow your branches, reaching the arms up overhead. Glutes are turned on here, hips are pressing forward in tree. Slowly bring that knee towards midline, lower it down into mountain pose. Relax the shoulders from the ears, reach the arms up, maybe bring the pinkies a little bit closer, help with the shoulder and the joint. And then I want you to toe heel your feet apart to about the width of the mat. So the heels are on the mat, the toes will be off. We're gonna do 5 yogi squats here. Inhale, arms sweep up overhead. Exhale, hinge the hips first. That'll turn on the muscles that we wanna use here. And then let the knees track out over the toes so the hands come down. Press into the earth now. Big toe mound, little toe mound, and heel. Both foot. Feel how strong you are as you inhale and rise up. Exhale, lower down. Pressing into the earth, inhale, rise. Exhale, lower. 2 more, inhaling up. Exhale, down. Last one, inhaling up. Now you know on the last one, we go all the way down to the floor without the use of our hands. Good job. All right. That seemed like a lot, but it's good. Let's come into half board of the fish. So seated comfortably on your mat, we're going to bend the left knee, step the left foot over the right, left hand comes behind the body, fingertips are pointed away, inhale, grow through the crown of the head, reach the right arm up towards the sky, exhale, right elbow comes to the outside edge of the left knee as we twist, we're growing through the crown of the head on the inhale, exhale, contract your core, twist a little bit further. Gaze starts to make its way over the left shoulder. Right foot is active here. Bend it back towards your nose. Don't just let it hang out wherever it is. Press through that heel. Bend the toes back through the nose. Remember, inhale. Grow, exhale, twist. Nice long spine here. You have a mirror around, you can see you want this crown of the head and a straight line with the spine all the way down to the floor. Two more breaths here. Now a quick counter pose, we're gonna release the right elbow, bring the left elbow to the inside edge of the left knee, twist to the other side just for a second. Let that go. Stretch the left leg out long, bend the right knee, step the right knee over the left leg. Right hand goes behind the body, fingertips are pointing away. Left foot is active, we're pressing into that heel, curling the toes back. Inhale, the left arm up. Exhale, left elbow to the outside edge of the right knee and twist. Now grow, inhale, grow through the crown of the head. Exhale, twist a little further. Eventually your gaze makes its way over the right shoulder. Release the hand, quick counter pose, right elbow to the inside edge of the right knee, twisting the other side, and let that go. Sit onto your hip, bring the leg behind you, we're coming into child's pose here. So toes come together, knees are apart, about as wide as your mat, maybe a little wider or narrow, depending on how you're feeling today. And then just relax into your mat, you can reach the arms out in front of you, extending up onto the fingertips to get into your shoulders, or you can bring the hands behind you, rest them on top of the feet for a fallen leaf. Yogi's choice here, whatever's best for you. I'm going to get into my shoulders and chest a little bit and reach the arms out. Inhale, puff up that space in the back of the body. Exhale, belly button towards spine. Two more breaths here. Let something go. And slowly come up to a seated position. Bring the knees together. Rabbit pose here. We're going to sit back onto the heels. Inhale your arms up overhead. Hands come together, and then we're going to dive forward, trying to bring the knife edge of the hand and the forehead down to the floor at the same time. Once the hands touch, stretch them out long, keeping the hips connected to the heels, reaching the hips back, arms stretching forward, forehead is on the mat, biceps are behind the ears. Deep inhale, puff up the chest. Exhale, belly button towards spine. Starting to wiggle around in this pose, find the comfortableness. Breathe into any discomfort. Work it all out. And then slowly come out of this the same way you went in, keeping the biceps by the ears. We'll inhale up. Exhale, let it go. Now sitting back on our heels, inhale your arms up overhead, interlace your fingers, point the palms up towards the sky like we did in the beginning, relax those shoulders away from the ears, and then we'll reach over to the right, stretching that left side body. Gaze can be straight ahead or up underneath the left armpit. Keep that core engaged. We're not flaring the ribs out here. Remember, we're filling up the back of the lungs, getting into that rib cage. Inhale back up to center. Exhale to the other side. Reaching, pressing down into that right hip. Shoulders relax away from the ears. Don't flare the ribs. Inhale, grow. Exhale, squeeze. Coming back to center. Release the hands. Sit onto your left hip. Bring the legs out in front of you. Bend the knees in towards the chest. Mitt, you want to scoot up a little bit on your mat. We're going to rock onto our backs, just shoulder blades to heels, back and forth a couple times. Nice and easy. And then we'll end up flat on our backs. Stretching that left leg out long. Bend the right knee in towards your chest. Interlace your fingers around the shin. And pull that right knee back towards your armpit. Avoiding the rib cage here. Start to rotate the ankle clockwise and counterclockwise. Preparing for a supine twist, we're gonna take the right leg, drag it across the body, scoot the hips a little bit to the right so when the knee comes across, the hips are stacked on top of each other. Inhale that right arm up towards the sky. And then on your exhale, let it fall to the floor. Gaze follows your hand as you twist. Deep inhale, fill up the chest. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, expand. Exhale, let something go. Relax into the twist. Inhale the legs back up through center. Bend the knees in towards your chest for happy baby. Elbows to the insides of the knees, hands to the outsides of the feet. Maybe rock back and forth a little here. Massage for the spine. Trying to stack the ankles over the knees, bringing that whole spine onto the floor. Release the feet down to the floor. Stretch the legs out long. Bend that left knee in towards your chest. Interlace your fingers. Maybe take an awkward grip this time. Opposite finger on top. And pull that knee back towards your armpit. Avoiding the rib cage. Start to roll the ankle. Both directions. Preparing for supine twist, we're going to drag the left knee across the body, scoop the hips to the left a couple inches, and bring the knee down. Hips are stacked on top of each other. Inhale that left arm up towards the sky. Exhale, let it fall to the floor. Gaze follows your hand as you start the twist. Deep inhale, fill up the chest. Exhale. Relax into the twist. Let something go here. If you have a thought floating around in your mind, just let it go. Maybe unclench the jaw. Take the tongue off the roof of the mouth. Two more breaths. Inhale the legs back up through center. Since I have twin babies, I do two happy babies at the end of every class. Bend your knees in towards your chest, elbows to the insides of the knees, hands to the outsides of the feet for a second happy baby. Take any modification you might need here, whether that's extending one leg at a time, maybe rocking back and forth. Find what works for you. Just work on stacking those ankles over the knees and bringing that whole spine onto the floor. That usually means the tailbone is up, so try to work to press the tailbone down towards the floor, but keep the ankles stacked over the knees. A lot of times when you do that, you might lower the feet. It's kind of a balancing act there. Release the feet. Extend the legs out long. Preparing for Shavasana, let the feet fall open as they may. Hands are away from the sides of the body, trying to bring all 10 fingernails onto the floor, palms facing up. Roll your shoulders up and then back down, creating a nice little platform for the heart. Rock your head from side to side. Find a comfortable resting position for the head. And just relax into the earth. Allow gravity to do its job. Give yourself an A for joining this class. The most important part of yoga is showing up. I invite you to stay in your Shavasana for as long as you can, enjoying the fruits of your labor. This is where I'll leave you today. Have a great start to your week, and we'll see you again on Friday. Take care.